What's your 0 to 60? Well, you got 2 horsepower.
Yes, we do.
Hey, everybody, it's your good buddy 650 Eep here, and I'm with my good buddy 5UP. We're in his hometown near Detroit, Michigan. And I want to reintroduce a motorcycle to my channel. It's my 2015 Yamaha R1M. I absolutely love this motorcycle, but I've had issues with it over the last couple of years. They were issues that I created. I had my ECU flashed a couple of years ago when I first got the bike, and the throttle was way too choppy. I recently had the ECU reflashed again from the same company that initially did it, Superbike Unlimited, and they totally resolved that issue. The throttle was now mint. Sadly, right after that, I hit a pothole in filthy Cleveland, bent my front rim, and so the bike had a wobble at speeds over 100 miles an hour. But thank goodness my good buddy Brock's Performance sent me a set of Rotobox RBX2 wheels that I've recently installed on the bike.
We put the stock R1M wheel on the scale with the rotors on them and spacers, and it was 25 pounds. Now we have the awesome Rotobox carbon fiber wheels on the scale with the brake rotors and spacers and everything, and it is 23 pounds. So that is a 2 pound difference for the front wheels with tires. We're gonna find out what happens with the rear wheel and tires in just a second. But I will tell you this, the Rotobox wheels, you can't deny that, look a lot better. Stock R1M rear wheel with the hubs and brake pads and all that and sprockets. And it weighs 33 pounds.
Okay.
Rear Rotobox wheel with the sprocket and everything else attached to it. And it weighs 28 and a half pounds. Wow, that's a pretty significant difference compared to the stock rear wheel.
Steve, how do those wheels look?
Those wheels look really good. I'm noticing the lettering, the Rotobox insignia, swinging around. Not that I could read it going 50 miles an hour, but it definitely brings attention and breaks up the wheel as it's going down the road here.
And you also have a set of carbon fiber wheels on your magnificent S1000RR. You have the BST carbon fiber wheels, and you added a red striping around the wheels. I think that looks magnificent.
Yeah, I had to break it up a little bit, and I didn't want to lose the red that this bike originally came with, so we incorporated quite a bit of the factory BMW red into the carbon fiber pieces I added to it.
Looks amazing. We're going to go over Steve's bike in greater detail, but everything about this man's bike is completely custom. Looks fantastic. Meanwhile, my fuel light is on, so we're going to get some fuel. We're going to fuel up right now, but look at these amazing bikes. Totally, totally gorgeous. Side by side. I got to get those blue hoses you got, Steve.
They do add more power.
They add about 5 horsepower, according to my estranged son, Trans Am Guy 73. But Steve,
I wish I would have purchased them in red. I guess you can get them in red. So.
Oh, what do you think about the spokes of the Rotobox wheels?
I like the detail of the actual carbon fiber matting. The spokes, they're large. I know these are a lighter wheel than the BSTs. And, a lot of people think that they're actually better quality also, which is very well could be true. But they're a heavy spoke, but these are a hollow spoke.
Yes.
So that's why Rotoboxes end up a little bit lighter than a BST.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm looking at your spokes now, and you can hardly see them back there, dude. You know, I think that the thinner spokes look better on, like, the H2, an application that uses a single-sided swing arm. But I think with the double-sided swing arm, I want to see more carbon fiber. I paid good money for it, or in my case, they were gifted. But nonetheless, I still want to see that magnificent carbon fiber. 1, 2, go! All right, tough guy. Let's see what you're made of. 1, 2, go!
Where were you?
Real funny, tough guy, real funny.
I got to give you a little bit of room.
Yeah.
I will. This bike's fast as hell, man.
Yeah, it is. I can definitely tell it's got 16 more horsepower than this.
Yeah, it's a lot faster than it used to be.
Now we're just going to do a quick drive-by of some of these awesome cars here at the Woodward Avenue. It's not really a bike night. It's something that goes on every week here. Lots of sweet cars. What's up, buddy? We got a freaking Ford GT. Looking awesome. Cool, guys. 370. Might be a Nismo. Another 370. We got a Viper. We got an ATS V. Really nice. We got a Ducati. We got a brand new Lamborghini Spider Huracan. Gorgeous. Audi, Subaru, Camaro, Corvette, Z06. Ah, there's my buddies from earlier.
What year is this?
2015.
Oh, nice, man. Supercharger, 650 horsepower, 650 torque.
Yeah,
you got the plaque right there.
Yeah.
Nice.
It's got the K-Tech stage 2.
So, oh, really?
Yeah, so it's like 640 wheel motor.
Wow, let's hear this thing. Thanks, man. Now I need a fucking hearing aid. Awesome, it sounds great, man. Congratulations. I just put a video riding my buddy's Z06 on my YouTube channel. Check it out.
All
right,
man.
Yeah, now let's check yours out, man. You're not going to be ignored. I know you've got the C6 Z06, right?
Yeah, his is pretty nice.
Nice.
Debut day, so it's hard to beat that.
You guys going to do some smackdowns?
He's got me about 150 horse.
100, so you've got 500 horse?
It's like 580, I guess, some mods.
Now, this is supercharged as well, right?
No, 7 liter.
Okay. And that's supercharged.
Header's intake too.
Awesome. And this guy's got an M3. You guys are just having too much fun, man. How much horsepower do you have?
I don't know, 420.
420? I don't know. It's just 420. Awesome.
Sitting next to these two is not too much, though.
Yeah. I like the wheels on your Z06 too, man. I like the chrome. It's nice. All right, guys. I'm not going to hold you up. Let's see if you can show me a little something when you guys get out of here, man.
Nice. Very nice.
That's probably the Mustang Shelby you don't want to fuck with right there when it's got a big tire on that.
Oh, yeah. But I do. I'll mess with this guy. We're going to double T. Is this the Viper ATS or whatever the hell with the fancy front spoiler? Uh-huh.
Say on the side of it there.
It says Viper SRT10.
Yeah. Oh, wow. What a cock block.
Ducati Detroit. I don't think the Viper wants to dance with us.
No, I don't think he does.
I'd love to smack him down. My viewers would love to see him get smacked down. But he wants no part of it. You want a smack down, Potbelly? We just ate at Potbelly's, and here's the owner of Potbelly's. Yeah, I hear you. He doesn't want any piece of this. There's the cops up there. You see, Potbelly, we can get away from the cops. You can't, you know? You might be, but he's probably a judge or something, so it doesn't really matter. How do you like that R1M, Steve?
I'm liking it.
Wow. How about the throttle? How's the throttle feel?
It's very responsive, but it's not choppy.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so from engine XL to XL, I mean, you can definitely work it back and forth or whatever. It's very little input, but I can ride the bike one-handed and definitely get used to the throttle.
I actually like the way the R1M looks with those carbon fiber wheels because...
Hold on.
Well, and obviously I like the way it sounds too, but I like the way it looks with the Rotobox carbon fiber wheels because now the wheels aren't blue and it ties into carbon fiber that is on the bike.
Yeah, no, it looks great. There is a lot of carbon on this bike too.
Mm-hmm.
This bike definitely lays down for
torque. Yeah, you can feel the torque.
Yeah, it just has a great amount of work. This is what we talked about with the R1M and any of the R1s. That's the same as the quarter exiting availability. You use red tires on this bike up in Ohio.
Yeah.
Accelerating too hard out of quarters because bike control electronics keep you from being on your front, back, and middle side.
Right.
How do you like how that thing feels?
I like it a lot, man. I've always liked the S1000 HP4. I mean, I call this bike old reliable. I can jump on it. I'm very familiar with the settings. The power is outstanding. It's not as light as that R1M, so that means for me, it's more controllable. When I launch, it's much easier to control this thing than it is on the R1M. So.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to putting my BMW HP4 back into circulation. Next week when I pick it up, I'm having its 18,000 mile service completed. And also installing my awesome new Bridgestone S21 tires onto it.
They're getting installed right now, aren't they?
Yeah, they're on that bike and they look great. I love the tire pattern and they feel great. I mean, the bike felt really responsive and handled well. It cornered well with those very sticky S21 tires on it. One, two, go! One, two, go!
You hanging up, YouTube?
What's that? No. You know what I did? I let you go because I wanted to skywalk you because I knew I would destroy you. I probably shouldn't have done that.
You have a concern?
Huh? I let you go first so I can try to skywalk you.
Yeah, you probably shouldn't do that with me.
One, two, go!
Makes me want this bike even more.
Oh, yeah.
This thing was cooking.
We had an excellent time here riding these beautiful bikes. I'm on Steve's S1000 right now, and it's riding great. It performs great. Steve is on my R1M. And Steve, what do you think of that bike in closing?
Dude, it's awesome. You know, the amount of power that it just showcased that it had versus rider weight, whatever, subjective. But I love the gauges. I love how nimble. I rode this bike shortly around some twisties. I still had the stock wheels on it, and it's only gotten better with the Rotobox supplied by Brox.
Wow, that's impressive. Yeah, your bike is awesome too with the BST wheels. So stay tuned. Yeah, you're welcome, man. So stay tuned for more videos of me and Five Up on the channel. Links to his channel is in the description. If you like this video, hit the like button. You can subscribe to my channel by clicking subscribe. New videos are always uploaded. Stay tuned for more, and as always, thanks so much for viewing. Yeah, he's having a ball.